Hello everyone, I'm Rohini and today I'm going to show you how to perform Vipreet Bend Asana using a yoga wheel. So first get a yoga wheel, you can buy it from Amazon or you can even check at your yoga center. Then turn around, place the wheel at the back around your lower back. So as you're seated, like so the way I'm seated with the knees slightly bent and the legs are hip width apart. Then of course check your hair, that your hair should not interfere. Then place the wheel at the bottom, okay, and slowly start rolling back on the wheel, placing your spinal cord on top of the wheel, supporting and balancing there, pressing the feet firmly into the floor, drawing the navel in, go on the wheel like so, like you're in a bridge pose, and then look up and then allow the hands to go back and then hold the wheel. And then go look back all the way and then start rolling back until your elbows touch the ground, like so, and breathe deeply here, placing the crown of the head on the floor, raising the hips up but not squeezing the butt too much. Just keep the hips slightly semi-contracted, not too contracted and not too loose, but slightly semi-contracted. Breathe deeply. Now extend the leg slightly to the front. So you get a straight knee here. And breathe deeply. So your abdomen stretches in two opposite directions. This is a great stretch for your core. And then once you're done, you come back. Release the hand first. Place it like so, the way I'm placing on the floor, and then slowly start rolling up, okay, and come in the center, cross your legs and breathe deeply. So that's how you perform your Vipreet Dandasana using a yoga wheel. Now you can also perform this asana using an Iyengar yoga chair, which I will be making a video of soon, so stay tuned. So there are two wonderful variations that you can perform this particular asana, and this is very good for your heart. People who are suffering from respiratory disorders, very beneficial for them, very good for your lungs, very good for your back, your spine. It's an intermediate pose, it's a deep back bend, and you will see that as easy as it looks, even with the yoga wheel on, you will notice that if you perform it, it wouldn't be that easy, especially if you're tight around here, your near your rotator cuff and your upper back and your neck muscles. It will not be easy even with this yoga wheel on. So there are certain practices that you need to do in order to open up your upper back, neck, and these muscles, the rotator cuff and the upper back muscles and the neck muscles especially. And I will make a video of those exercises, but if you just browse through the history of my previous videos, I have given some videos on how to open up your shoulders and your rotator cuff, and they're pretty much the same exercises which you have to do. Or if you're going to a yoga studio, if you're going to your yoga center, then you will be given so many exercises which are actually increasing the mobility here, enhancing the flexibility here. Without that, don't even try to attempt this even with the yoga wheel on. It's not easy. It's only easier for those who have a bit of flexibility there, but the ones who are pretty stiff, for them as well this won't be sufficient. So my request is that you please first practice the basics and open up your upper back muscles, shoulder muscles and neck muscles, and then go on to the yoga wheel. And you can even do it with the Iyengar yoga chair, which I will soon make a video of separately, so stay tuned. So I hope you enjoyed this practice and keep practicing, and any questions please let me know. Thank you very much. Goodbye guys.